Hey, Ross World, My Money Makes Money. Credit Class, Part 2 of 7. Part 2 of 7. Credit history. Now, according to FICO, your credit history makes up 35% of your credit score, according to them. Now, we're going to leave Vantage alone. Vantage 3.0, that was actually made up by the three credit agencies, TransUnion, Experian, and Equifax. So we're just going to focus on FICO because 90% of American companies look at your FICO score rather than all the other agencies with their Vantage 3.0. So 35% of your credit history makes up your FICO credit score. And how you can tell these things, guys, go to annualcreditreport.com and request your annual free credit report. And you'll have all these things on there, all these things that you didn't even know that was being reported, whether it be your credit cards, your personal loans, your car loans, your mortgage loans, even your rental property. This thing, anything that you applied for or that you got approved for or any of the above may have hit your credit report. Now, people will give you a list of everything that's reported on your credit report. Let me tell you something. Everything goes on your credit report, okay? Everything goes on your credit report. Even the things that don't go on your credit report, they go on your credit report, okay? That's the way you have to look at it. But nonetheless, so your credit history depends on exactly what it is. It's kind of like if you was a convict, right? You went to jail for whatever reason. Just using this as an example, okay? This doesn't mean you actually went to jail. Anyway, you know how when they fill out an application for employment, they have to put that they serve time in jail? That is how your credit history is. So if you took out a loan to pay off your debt, okay, that's the whole reason for your credit history. It shows missed payments, no payment, it went into collections. That all makes up that 35% of how they generate your credit score. This is how they generate your credit score because you have to be consistent. You have to be a good boy. You have to be a good girl in order to get that 720 or above. Now, granted, according to a lot of financial institutions, you need to have a 630 credit score in order to get a Fannie Mae loan for a home or other source of financial support and loans from all these other institutions. So the number you really want is 720, because a lot of financial institutions or people that you're trying to get loans from, they look at a 720 the same way they look at an 800 or 850 in some cases, not all. But the 720 golden tick is where you want to be. 35% of your credit score is made up from your credit history. So if you're missing payments or you're late on payments, now whatever you're talking to with these guys on the phone, like, oh, I know I'm late, I'm gonna pay this. Oh, okay, sir, they're gonna work with you. But in the background, they don't tell you that your credit score is being affected. That is why every year, and some people do it every 3 months, if you're doing a lot of things with your credit. If you're not making moves with your credit a lot, then every year is just fine. But if you're doing some things here and there, maybe every 3 months, maybe every 6 months. And here's another good tool. Go to creditkarma.com and have an account. That way you can track your TransUnion and your Equifax credit score. Then if you go to credit.com, I think they actually help you with your Experian totally free. So here's some tips. Pay your bills on time. Don't be late. Also, if you know you're going to be late, give them a call in advance to work out a payment plan or to freeze your account, put your account in deferment, whatever they can use to help you so it doesn't show up late, which in turn affect your credit score. Because here's the thing, guys, it doesn't matter you have buku money or it doesn't matter you have a little bit of money. Every now and again, even millionaires take out loans from other billionaires in order to get their business moving, for product, for whatever the case may be. And most of this depends on your credit score or your ability to pay it back, because that is your judgment, okay? That is your convict track record, okay? Oh, okay, well, he got out at a certain time, but we still got a judge on that. Now, here's another golden nugget for you. If you have an account, if you have something on your credit report that is past the 7-year, 3-month mark, And the reason why I say, most people say 7 years, but there's this real algorithm, there's this real mathematical equation. I just wanna go with 7.3, 7 years, 3 months. If you have an account on your credit report that's older than 7.3 and is in collections, is not in good standing, then you need to dispute them. I have some letters that I will send to you totally free, okay? My email's in the description, and give me a thumbs up, please. But anyway, I have those letters, I'll send them right out to you, no muss, no fuss, in order for you to dispute those credit accounts that are past the 7 year, 3 month mark, because they're supposed to take those accounts off. Now granted, here's another one. Sometimes collection agencies, they continue to sell your account to refresh it on your credit report to make it seem like it's new, forcing you, right, causing stress, depression, to pay it. But no, from that first account, once it hits collection, if it's past 7 years and 3 months, they supposed to delete it off your credit report according to the Fair Credit Reporting Act of 2003, somewhere around there, 2003, yeah. But anyway, so take care of your credit history, guys, because it makes up 35% of your credit score according to FICO. So without muss, this is Ross World. Credit history is the most important part of making up your credit score according to FICO. And this is what you really want to take care of right here, right now. This is part two of a 7-series video series to help you raise your credit score and get right. This is Ross World. I'm out.